Hi world. I am 38 weeks pregnant now, and I just wanted to do an update, let you guys know how the progress is going and what's going on with my pregnancy. For being 38 weeks pregnant, I have been very emotional about my C-section because it is scheduled. And I don't really believe in scheduled anything unless it's for dentist visits or, you know, immunization shots. My tummy is also really big, and it's been extremely hard to get up to go use the restroom throughout the night, which could be, you know, from 5 to 10 times before I even really shut down and go to sleep. I don't have a sleep schedule, and sometimes I would be awake until 11, I would be awake from 11 a.m. until 8 a.m. and sleep from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. So it's 3 hours of sleep, and that's all I need, and I would be awake. A couple of my food cravings, since I haven't been mentioning, I have been craving for Korean tofu soup, Thai curry noodles, papaya salad, bamboo. It's a place like Starbucks, but it's a Vietnamese spot for drinks and desserts. I've been also craving for Starbucks. Lately, I've been feeling pressured on time. I feel like there's so many things to do and not enough time. I haven't packed my hospital bag yet at 38 weeks, and I know I have to. I've been taking bubble baths every single night before bedtime, so my bubble bath usually starts around 4 or 5 a.m., and then I have a routine I follow, and then around 8 a.m. or 7:30 a.m., I fall asleep, get 3 hours of sleep, and then I'm busy the whole day again. I did go take my maternity photos. I kind of showed it in my hospital bag video, but I haven't really got a chance to really share it with you guys. I also did meet up with my friends to gain some support. I trust them with a lot of my feelings and, you know, what's going on in my life, and it's nice to get together with people who you care about or people that care about you so that you feel better. I've been spending more time with my baby girl. I bought her some new clothes and some new shoes because once I have my baby, I'm going to be at home for bed rest more than usual because I am a pretty busy person. I'm always running errands, I'm always trying to find activities and things and places to go, things to try out, whether it's with her or if it's with him. I tell her that I love her a lot, and I also give her more hugs and more kisses. I did have to buy some frozen foods, some snacks, and even canned food, just in case I can't cook or I can't really prepare food and I must have it right away. And I know that after a pregnancy, delivery and everything, the hunger rate is really not there. Especially for me, when I had my C-section and I was recovering, I slept most of the time because I was on a high dosage of medication that had me sleep for hours and hours. I couldn't fight the pain. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry, I can't cut off the sneeze. I am not editing this video, so bless my soul. Alright, I did file for EDD because they do cover a certain period of time that I have to be off work, And then from there, we'll see how things go. I may not even go back to work, but I can definitely, use the money to help out with not using as much money that's been used so far from the savings account. I've been reviewing what I need to be packing for my hospital bag and just wanted to make sure that everything that I need is available and accessible. I've been organizing clothes around the house, house items, doing loads and loads of laundry, and just prepping. Trying to figure out what else. So yeah, I guess my favorite pastime right now would be taking bubble baths before I go to bed. It really helps relax me, and I even got some lavender oil, 100% pure essential oils, to drop some in my bath water along with Dr. Teal's foaming bubble lavender thing. It's in the restroom. I'm kind of tired, so I'm not gonna be showing too many visuals. And then I also got Lush dusting powder, which I'm obsessed with right now. Sometimes my body starts to get sweaty, I get hot really easily. So what dusting powder does is, besides smelling really good on you, it kind of blocks your body from breaking out sweat. And I also like to apply my tummy cream, and then I like to dust my tummy cream with the dusting powder. So it kind of locks the cream in, and then I don't feel as itchy. And it's been working, so. Well, before I go, I wanted to let you know that I did have my last doctor's appointment. I weigh 139 pounds. Which is funny because when I went into labor, I went in weighing 139 pounds too. So it's a really weird coincidence. My stomach is measuring 39 centimeters. Let me show you. So here's my stomach. It's measuring 39 centimeters. I had to schedule my 2 week and my 6 week postpartum appointments, which I did already. I had to schedule my C-section, which is coming up right on the corner, and I have to go in for a lab 1 to 2 days before my C-section. I did contact the hospital trying to arrange for a private room, but it's not guaranteed, so I hope I can get a private room. It is more convenient, it's less, you get more privacy, more space too. Yeah, I have to arrange somebody to watch my daughter, and I have to go in 2 hours before my scheduled time so that they can give me my IV, set me up. Do things that they need to do before the actual C-section. So I guess I'm kind of nervous and excited, but here's my belly. It's really big. It's probably bigger than the last time. I didn't put any tummy cream on. I only put my dusting powder on tonight just because I didn't feel like putting on tummy cream. So, yeah, that's my 38-week update for you. I will be going in for my baby's delivery when I reach 39 weeks and 1 day. And that's coming right up. So, I have a lot to do, a lot to stress about. And I kind of want her to be here early, but I guess we might have to force her out. Alright, thanks for watching. Looks like this pregnancy is slowly coming to an end. I'm I'm glad that all of you followed, and I'll keep you updated. Take care.